And now we will learn about a very important security feature, setting a closing date. A closing date is the date where no transactions before this date may be added, changed, or removed, unless, of course, you have the closing date password. Anything before the closing date should not be changed because those numbers have already been submitted to the government and different departments of government like the IRS. Anything you recorded after the closing date is no problem, and you can edit and change and add and delete anything you want. To make a closing date, the administrator must use the preferences window and set up a closing date password. So the administrator decides what the closing date is, and the administrator decides the password. You don't have to set up users and passwords to put on a closing date password. You're automatically logged in as the administrator if you did not set up users and passwords. So that means just create the file, don't even deal with usernames and passwords, and go ahead and go to the preferences window and put in a closing date and a password. You're automatically logged in as the administrator if you did not set up users and passwords. So, let's open a file where users and passwords are not set up, and we'll put a closing date and a password. Let's make the closing date July 31, and let's make the password $500. This is a very famous password for a closing date, because accountants will tell their clients, if you change something before the closing date, I'm going to charge you $500 to come out there and fix it. So let's take a look at how it would look. Let's be sure that in the file that is open, we have no usernames and passwords set up. If we click Company, Set Up Users and Passwords, and click Set Up Users, you see right now we only have the admin. So I'm logged in as admin because I never set up users and passwords. If we click Edit User, you can see a password was never given, which means I never set up users and passwords. So now let's go ahead and put on the closing date and password. From the top left of the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. Now, the preferences for closing date are in the accounting category in the Company Preference tab. Go down to the bottom of the window and click Set Date and Password. Now again, the closing date will be July 31, and the password will be, take off cap locks, $500, and again, $500. Now we click OK. Then click No Password Entered. The company does not have an administrator password set. So this is just a pop-up warning. It's not an error, it's a warning. It's only warning you that you did not set up users and passwords, but it will still allow you to put a password on the closing date. We're going to click Yes. Okay, and then click Close, click OK. Now we have set up a closing date with a password. Let's see if it works. We're going to open one of the registers, and we're going to try and delete something that was entered before July 31. Edit, Delete Deposit. You cannot do this without the password. But if we type in the password, $500, and then we click OK. Are you sure you want to delete? Click OK. So it does allow us to change something, but only if we have the password. And as you can see, that's true even if there's no usernames or passwords set up, because by default, we're logged in as the administrator. So if we know that only the administrator can set up or change the closing date password, that means that if you're not the administrator, you need permissions to change any transaction before the closing date, and then you also need the closing date password. So we have already set up a user named Jill in a previous video. And as you can see, in the last stages of setting Jill's username and password, we told QuickBooks, no, she does not have the ability or the permission to change closed transactions. That's transactions before the closing date. Okay, now we click Finish. And let's see if Jill can change one of the transactions in July. Now, after a brief pause, here we are logged into the same file as Jill. Let's open one of the transactions during July that Jill would normally have access to. For example, this July 28th check. Let's see what happens when we try to delete it. Up, look what the warning says. You cannot perform this action because the transaction's date is before the closing date. You need permissions to modify transactions before the closing date to do this. Please ask your administrator. So QuickBooks did not even ask us for a password because this particular user was not given permissions to change anything before the closing date, even if she had a password. And now let's give Jill permission. Now, after a brief pause off camera, I logged back in as the administrator. And now we're going to alter Jill's permissions. It's very simple. Set up users and passwords. Again, put in the administrator password. And we're going to edit Jill the user. We're going to fast forward all the way to the end where it asks, should this user be allowed to change transactions before the closing date? Now we're going to say yes, click next, and now you can see Jill now has the ability to change transactions before the closing date. We're going to click finish. Now we're going to log back in as Jill. So after a brief pause off camera, I logged off as the administrator and logged back into the same file as Jill. Now let's see if we can delete that July check. Banking, write a check, go back to the checks that are in July, and now let's see what happens when we click delete. Aha! It will allow us to do it, but even though Jill has permission to change it, she still has to type in the password $500. Now when I click OK, it says, are you sure you want to delete it? Click OK, and the transaction has been deleted. A great security feature that goes along with the closing date is the closing date exception report. The closing date exception report shows every change to every transaction before the closing date. It will also show the date and time of the change and exactly who changed it. Now, even though the format is somewhat similar to the audit trail, this report sorts all the changes by user. So it may look like it's repeating information because it might be that two separate users changed the same transaction. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Closing Date Exception Report. Now, notice all the transactions listed here are the transactions entered or modified by the admin. All the transactions down here are the transactions entered or modified by Jill. And in both sets, there's only one. You can see July 1 was when this particular check, dated July 28th, was originally entered by the administrator. And then you can see on July 7th, at a little after 1 o'clock, it was deleted by Jill. Now, that's the information about what the administrator did and who else changed the administrator's information. Down here, it looks like a repeat, but it's really not. It's Jill's information. Because if Jill was involved in any of the changes, it'll be listed down here, even if it's listed in another user's section of this report. So the very same check that the administrator entered on July 1, Jill deleted on July 7th, and that information is also shown in the section of Jill.